Finance Chapter, Section 3, Making an Amortization Schedule. In this section, we will show how amortization schedules are created. Our goal will not be to create an entire schedule, just to find the breakdown for the first two or three payments. In this example, we're borrowing $21,000 at 7% interest for 5 years. Our first step to fill in this amortization schedule will be to calculate the monthly payment. We'll use the loan table to calculate this. On the loan table, we'll find the intersection between the 7% interest and the 5 years, and from that table, that value is $19.80. We're multiplying it by 21 because the table is set up for monthly payments for $1,000 borrowed, and we're borrowing $21,000, or 21 times as much. That gives us a monthly payment throughout the entire 5 years of $415.80. We're now ready to start calculating some of the values in the table. First off, we'll calculate the interest owed on this first month. We have a beginning balance. We haven't paid any money. And to find the interest portion of our monthly payment, we use the simple interest formula. We owe $21,000 because we haven't made a payment. The interest rate is 7%, and we're multiplying it by time and years of 1/12, the equivalent of 1 month. In lieu of timesing by 1/12, you could divide by 12 to give you an interest rate of $122.50. That's the portion of our monthly payment that is going towards the cost of borrowing this money. What's left over constitutes the principal. So to calculate the principal, we take the monthly payment that we calculated, $415.80, subtract the interest, resulting in $293.30. It's this principal portion that reduces the amount that we owe. So taking the beginning balance minus the principal will result in our ending balance. The ending balance turns into the beginning balance of line 2, and the process starts over with calculating the interest. Because of that first monthly payment, we owe less, and because we owe less, our interest will be less. Using the simple interest formula, we'll take our balance from line 2 times the interest rate of 7% times the time of 1 month for this amount that's owed to give us an interest payment of $120.79. That interest will be subtracted from the monthly payment to calculate our principal, and the principal then reduces the amount of our loan. So that value is indicated in the ending balance column. $20,706.70 less the principal gives us an ending balance of $20,411.69 after two payments on this loan. Here's another example. Here we're borrowing $70,000 at 6.5% interest for 20 years. Start an amortization schedule, we begin with finding the monthly payment. Using the loan table, we will look up 6.5% along with 20 years, which is a value of 7.46, multiplying it by 70 because we're borrowing $70,000 compared to the $1,000 in the table. That results in a monthly payment throughout the 20 years of this loan of $522.20. The interest for the first payment is calculated by finding the result of multiplying the principal, which is the beginning balance, times the interest rate as a decimal, times time of 1 month, or 1/12. That results in a value of $379.17. That will be subtracted from the monthly payment, and the leftover portion counts as the principal. The principal is what reduces our loan, So our ending balance will be the difference between the beginning balance, $70,000, and the portion of our monthly payment that counted towards the principal. That results in an ending balance in line one and a beginning balance of line two of $69,856.97. We begin the process again. We owe less, so our interest will be slightly less. It's still calculated using the simple interest formula, principal, the amount owed after the first payment, times the interest rate of 6.5% for a month, 1/12. That interest amounts to $378.39. That's subtracted from the monthly payment, and the leftover amount is equivalent to the principal of $143.81. To determine the ending balance, we take the principal portion of our monthly payment and subtract that from the balance to give us an ending balance of $69,713.16. This would continue on with calculating interest, principal, ending balance for the remaining payments in that 20-year loan. You're now ready to try some practice on your own, found on page 48.